sweetie, as all parents do, Dad and I always dreamed of you living a happy, healthy, and productive life and finding the kind of love that makes your heart thump and gives you that comfortable, confident feeling of forever love. No doubt that he's looking down on us today with that mile-wide smile and incredible sense of pride and love that you found, that everlasting love that you deserve. And I know that Jim would be so proud, Chris, to call you his son-in-law.
And our song just came out as I opened this.
Christopher, I can't believe the day has finally come. It seems like just yesterday we were standing here with a 500 plus day countdown, imagining what today would be like. To put it simply, it's a dream come true to have you waiting at the end of this aisle for me. I always pictured what today would be like, always wondered who would be standing there. I never imagined I would be so lucky to have it be you. Loving you has brought more light and love into my life than I knew existed. You have shown me the meaning of unconditional, everlasting love, and you have never for a moment given up on me. Today I vow to do the same for you. For the rest of this life and whatever awaits us in the next, I promise to never give up on us. I say this today knowing that we have mountains yet to climb, adventures that await, and unexpected hurdles to jump. I promise to love you as loyally and fiercely as you have loved me since the very first moment we met. I promise to take care of you when you're sicky. to support all of your goals and aspirations as if they were my own, to pick you up when you're low, to stand by your side during life's challenges, and to always put you and our family first. Most importantly, I promise to be the best wife I can be, to be your best friend and biggest supporter until my very last breath. Because becoming your wife today will always be my greatest accomplishment and my favorite thing I have ever been. I love you forever, Christopher Knight Roberts, no matter what.
Katie, we are a dying breed, those who have what we have. We've discovered that which everyone hopes to someday find. The light, the truth, the meaning of life. I've heard it said that God is love. I spent my whole life looking for God, and I only ever found him through you. You are my window to the divine. I give thanks that I won't spend another day on this earth being anything other than your husband. I don't only take you until death do us part. I take you forever, no matter what, in this life and the next, heaven or hell, I'll find you, I'll protect you, and I'll love you always.
And now, by the power vested in me by the state of Massachusetts for one day, it is my honor and delight to declare you married. Go forth and live each day to the fullest with the wind at your back and the sun upon your face. Chris, you may now kiss your bride. One more for good luck. Come on. And I am pleased to present the newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Roberts!
You know that it's 12 o'clock in Soho, baby. It's 10 o'clock.
Just like way back in the days of old. Suddenly we will float into the misty.
I recently saw a sign on the window of a coffee shop, and it was so simple, but it hit me so hard, and it made me think of this speech. It said, love lives here, and it just made me smile and think of you guys, and just makes me happy to know wherever you guys are, there's going to be love, and we're all going to see it and feel it. And here's to a beautiful life together.
I just wanted to say that I'm very thankful to be here to celebrate this special day with everyone. And I also want to be one of the first to welcome Auntie Katie into our family.
You know, like I said, as an older brother, I just want you to be happy, and I want you to be safe. And it couldn't make me happier, the person you chose to spend your life with. I love, Katie, I'm in love with you. I love you, you're.
So getting back to how I knew that Chris was the one, that special moment when I was sure Katie had found her future, it came in the form of a picture of their little Shih Tzu Max, now much older and mostly blind, being carried by Chris in a front pack baby carrier, out on a sidewalk, in public. It was then that I know that not only would Jim approve of Chris, but he would genuinely love him, not just for his, well, sense of humor, but also his extreme kindness and enormous heart. I knew that any man who would care so selflessly for a little elderly pup like that was not only meant for Katie, but had been sent for Katie.
Sweet darling, please don't leave me, don't you go, don't you leave me, baby, please don't leave me. Don't you go.
But when I woke up, I was all alone, with a broken heart and a ticket home. And I asked you, friends, what's a fella to do? 'Cause her hair was blonde and her eyes were blue. And I took her down, been all over the world. I've never seen nothing like my Galway girl. Then I ask you, well, what's a fella to do? If her hair was blonde and her eyes were blue. And I took her right there. I've been all over the world, but I've never seen nothing like my Galway girl.